Hello and welcome back. As you can see, I've put the roof on on the building. Haven't quite gotten to the point where I can make glass yet because I haven't made a furnace. So I'm gonna do that right now. But today, the idea was to head down and get. Do we have some raw like this? Yay! The idea was to get down and start the mine, so we can start collecting some resources. Do do do, and we got some coal. Yeah, because we are going to need a few bits of coal in order to. Spruce wood plank. Can we burn those? No. Boring. In order to get. Right over here. There. What was I saying? I think it. The thing that I wanted to say was that we need a couple of things. We need some torches, and we need some materials, and we need some food, obviously. Perhaps I should actually start by grabbing a bit of wood. Yeah, I think I'll do that, because I think I'll start by grabbing a bit of wood, and then... Was that my axe that broke immediately? This is going great. Anyways, grab a bit of wood so I can make some torches. Likewise, get me some... get me a hoe, and that way we can start planting some seeds in order to grow some wheat, so we can get some food going while we are down in the mine. And let's get this tree chopped down. Then we can get that bit of wood and one, and that wasn't much wood in that tree. Anyways, just be nice and replant the sapling here. Now we could use. I don't can't remember. Do I have seeds in there? Real seeds, not these henequen seeds and stuff like that. I don't know. Just clear out the area a bit. Corn. Corn is okay. We can make popcorn. Yay! And then we just need to figure out how to make a television and. We can watch movies and have popcorn. That'll be nice. Actually, perhaps we can make something quite into make something on the monitors in Computercraft that could be called a movie. I don't know, but it's gonna be a little bit before we dive into Computercraft. And there was that. That's a flax seed. So we got corn, henequen, and flax, but. We don't have any actual seeds. Come on, mate. Do I really have to head in and... I think I'm going to do that. Make me another seagull, perhaps. Now let's just get... Where did I... There... I can't figure out this... I don't know. So, first of all, yeah, let's make a seagull like that. Yeah, then let's make a... Who? Like that, yeah. Da da da, and let's check if we actually have some real seeds in here. We don't. Henequen seeds, corn canal, flax seeds. I don't want to. There, with lots of seeds. 13. I don't want to. Start planting that. The henequen, the flax, the corn, just yet. Do I? No, I don't. No, not yet. Not yet. But I want to get... oh yeah, I planted a couple of... reeds, sugar canes. If this one is one up, it won't get hydrated, will it? Can't remember. Ah. Come on. Okay, Oh, now we got more seeds to plant. I just wanted to clear out the area a bit. Let's count. 14. What? What? That's my egg. Where's my? There's my hole. So 14 it was. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. And let's plant this down, and then it can grow. Good. Grow. Now, you start growing. You hear me? Start growing. Right. Now, and of course, I used all the raw woods, which wasn't the idea, so I'm just gonna grab me a couple more. Come on. Let's get some wood. Yeah. Luckily, these trees ain't that high. I try to pick trees that are not that high. That's why I went past that one, because I don't want to try and get up in the top there. And yeah, I know. I was looking at some of the old, episode, I think it was, perhaps also in the second, actually. I did leave a couple of floating trees behind, so I'm sorry about that, and I'll get back and fix them. Where is that charcoal piece thing? What? Oh, I made I made a torch with it, didn't I? Yeah, I did. Oh well. This is just going perfectly. And we got a lot of dirt, it seems. Yeah, cool. We don't need what that's. Oh, that's our saplings. Okay, why? There's the ones that don't stack. I don't know why. I've got a piece of rubber. Cool. And some sand to make the windows. Yeah, I opted not to have a skylight for now. Perhaps we will get to that later. The thing about having a skylight is it makes for some cool lightning in the daytime, anyways. But I think with enough, I think we have if we just put in a glass here for now, we don't need the skylight anyways. So I think that's going to. Let's just grab. Come on, give me some more. I want to use charcoal for my basic burning stuff like that, because I want to save on the coal for later for something else. Coal is more valuable than charcoal, at least in my opinion, and I can see it's getting dark, so before we head into the dark, why don't we just take a quick nap? Good morning, sunshine. Good morning. And yeah, a wooden pickaxe. And I started actually this little thing in here, and then I ran into these, and I don't know what it is, and I wanted to have it on. And I can't even. Can I chop it? I can't even. What? I can't. Oh, I need. Actually, we should make one over here, shouldn't we? We should. We should make a crafting table over here, so we don't have to run back and forth. I usually do have a crafting table at my mines, so that'll be okay for now. And of course, I just need myself a couple of rocks. Let's get those right and make. My god, I'm. There we go. And make ourselves a stone pickaxe. Yay! Achievement get! Getting an upgrade. Yeehaw! Perhaps we can do this now. Yeah. And this is copper. I was kind of expecting that, to be honest. But, actually, it's a good thing. So, we are happy. Happy. We got copper raw. Yeah. And we can start getting our mine a bit more mined. Now, actually, I think in order to, is that real coal or is it some of that crude thingy? Is it, that's real coal. Oh, cool. For the most part, of course, right here at the beginning, I might have to resort to actually using the coal for some of my burning torch making things. But in order, in later, yeah, later, I will try to rely on charcoal for that. As I said, coal is more valuable than charcoal, in my opinion, for some different things. So. Let's get some lightning, actually, so we can see what we are doing. Okay. Sure, why not? I thought it would be a little bit darker, but okay. But at the beginning, it's sometimes a bit easier to get hold of coal than it is to get hold of charcoal until we get a bit of more automation up and running. Now, actually, hey, check this out. Oh. I forgot I only had half a heart because I haven't been eating. Oh my god. Nobody saw that, did they? Oh, we can say it was something else that killed me. But the point was that if you haven't played with SiteGraph before, or if you played with the old version, these was just quite nice to look at, but there wasn't really. And I'm going to turn. Where did I put? There we go. Waypoints, latest death, delete. Done. Back to the game. These were actually just for looks. It didn't do anything, but now they do damage. And there is some receipts that require it now. So where is that's the wooden pickaxe? What? Did I break the other one already? Or did it get lost? What? Oh my god, this takes a long time, doesn't it? Yeah, it does. No. Oh, what's that? I think it's amber. I'm not sure, but it's my best bet for now, because of the way it looks. So let's check it out and see if we do have amber. Now, of course, in order to start out here, we need a bit of basic materials. I can't even break it with a stone pickaxe. Okay, fair enough. I'll leave it for now then, until I get some iron. And that's what I'm after at the point anyway, because I want to grab myself some iron. In order to start out with the automation and stuff like that. So the actual idea here is, for the most part, is to dig down and create a bit of a mine down here in order to go actually way down. As we can see now, we're at 60, 61... 59 in the level that we are in. What do we have here now? Oh, what? Aluminum. Yeah, that's the one from SiteGraph. Yeah, right. In order to get down there at the bottom, or to around 12 and stuff, where we have the diamonds and. In fact, just grab a lot of resources on our way down here at the start, so we can build some of the funny machines. So yeah, that's basically it for now for this part. That is, go down here, dig, and hope for some nice stuff. Of course, that doesn't make for a interesting episode. So. Why don't we? There's a lot of gravel here, right? Why don't we do something else and then take the digging thing off camera. Right. Yeah, let's do that. So what can we start? Maybe we got a good amount of cobblestone, some gravel. Yeah, I was just thinking, what? We only got 17 cobblestone? Okay, that didn't sound right, and it wasn't. We had a lot more. Yeah, we don't have any more bones because we tried to tame that wolf, so actually, perhaps we should start to plant those. Now, there is a couple of very neat things we can do when we want to start planting and stuff like that, but for now, we can't really do anything because we are hurting for resources, and that's okay. We just need to head down into the mine to start out with. But as I said, that's not very interesting. So what I want to do instead is, what do we have? What do we have? What do we have? We have an hour. We have is perhaps. Start planting a bit of this instead. Now, I think, and actually, don't quote me, but let's get this, because we can always use some strings and stuff in order to make wool and other parts that needs string, and that's what we get from the flax. So we might as well plant some of the flax now we are at it. Plant perhaps some there. Make it a bit more interesting, not very. Have some corn and some flax. I mean, it's not like it's going to be very efficient or anything like that in the fashion I'm doing it here. The reason why I'm doing it like this is because I want to make it look a bit more chaotic, bit more wild, a bit more like it hasn't really been planted. It has just grown up. It's just grown from the nature itself. It's not something I've done. Of course, we know it's something I've done, but let's see. So that way we might make I think that's flex too. Yeah. The area we live in will be a bit more interesting to visit, to walk around and to look at, instead of it's all straight lines and stuff like that, and I don't know, to me that gets a bit boring at times. It's okay when you want to make something very efficient and the like, but if yeah, but it gets a bit boring to look at in the end. It's kind of, I don't know if you played. I mean, now one of the big things out there at the moment is like SimCity, right? It just came out, and you can build in SimCity a grid and base your city out of a grid, and it's probably one of the most efficient ways. I don't know in the new version because I haven't played the new version, but at least in the old versions, it was one of the ways to go. But the cities you build like that, they're quite boring and not very realistic. At least to start out with, I know that in some of the big cities, I don't know if you can call it. It's just that the cities are at least around here. Don't look like a big grid. I mean, they're a bit more sprawling in terms of having their roads curve, bend, do all sorts of things that rather than just looking like, yeah, Mister, I came here and made a city with a ruler, stuff like that. Anyways, I also try at times to apply the same principles when I build stuff in Minecraft, because it makes the look of the place that more interesting. Let's check out this. That's also why I actually built, and instead of just building my mine here down and going straight down like that, I build it like this, because it's I don't know, but it just looked more pleasing to me that it's not straight lines and stuff like that, because you really, I don't know if you actually been to some of the old, really old mines around. I got some an old chalk mine. I don't know if you can call it that in English. Not very far away from where I live. I can tell you one thing. It's not one big straight line down to the ground. So did it break like that? Okay. So at least we planted these, made them look a bit interesting, and the plan now, while I've been chatting, I think we are running a bit out of time, is to let's plant these actually while we add it a bit more like this also. I'd like to fix that, but there seems to actually be a hole down here. I don't know what that is. We should go down and check at some point. Anyways, what I was trying to say was that that I want we're just gonna wait a bit here and check out that I'm not gonna wait a bit here. That's not what I wanted to say, but before we can do anything, we need to start getting these to grow a bit. We need to gather some resources down in the mine, and I'll be doing that off camera, because that's not very interesting to look at. Gathering wood, gathering stone, gathering iron, stuff like that. The only thing that's worth mentioning is probably the characteristics of these different ores. As we saw, we found copper ore, and copper ore is one of the more interesting ores in this mod pack, I believe. As I said, this is a new mod pack to me, but anyways, if I look at the other mods in or the mods that I've played that has these kinds of ores, copper is a it's a very useful ore, and I'm don't quote me on this again, but I think, and because it's in the config file, so I can go check it out afterwards. But normally, it would spawn from 75. You can see we are on 64 here. At the level. Likewise, you can, if you don't know what I'm talking about, look over at the mini map and look at the number over at the mini map, and you can see where your X and Z and Y positions are in the world. And what I want to do is, when I jump, it changes up to that must be my Y position, and you can see that if I press F3. And we get this picture up here that I'm at Y is 63 and my feet position is 64. Oh no, that's my feet position. My Y position is 64.6. And if I hit one down, it changes from 62 at my feet, 63 at my eyes. It says 63 over at the minimap. So 61, 60. Yeah, 56. And stuff like cover ore will spawn in the range of 75 to 40, I think it is. So if you're mining for cover, it doesn't it won't pay off if you head down to level 12, where you would normally mine a big deal because you want to get diamonds, and diamonds are the best place to mine diamonds is at level 12. But you won't run into any copper down there. So if you want to get copper, you need to be up in this height instead. So that's what probably the one of the things that was worth mentioning. But otherwise, I don't think there's anything else interesting about mining as much. You can look up the different spawn locations, different spawn levels for the ores if you want to, and check that out. But at some point we will probably be looking at making some sort of an age in Mistcraft where we can have some better chance of getting resources. But for now, let's just try and set up our base, and to do that, well, I'm gonna go mining, and I'm gonna go chopping wood off camera, and then come back when we got enough stuff to start making some more interesting things. So for now, take it easy, and bye.